Since force is a vector, it is better to write Coulomb's law in vector notation. Let the position vectors of charges q1 and q2 be r1 and r2 respectively. We denote force on q1 due to q2 by f12 and force on q2 due to q1 by f21. The two point charges q1 and q2 have been numbered 1 and 2 for the convenience, and the vector leading from 1 to 2 is denoted by r21. Vector r21 equals to the subtraction of vector r2 and vector r1, that is r2 minus r1. In the same way, the vector leading from 2 to 1 is denoted by r12, where vector r12 is equals to vector r1 minus vector r2 equals to negative of vector r21. So remember that vector r12 is negative of vector r21. The magnitude of vectors r21 and r12 is denoted by r21 and r12 respectively, and remember that r12 equals to r21 in magnitude. The direction of a vector is specified by a unit vector along the vector. To denote the direction from 1 to 2 or from 2 to 1, we define the unit vectors, where unit vector r21 is equals to vector r21 divided by r21, that is its magnitude. And similarly, unit vector r12 is equals to vector r12 divided by its magnitude. Note that unit vectors r21 are obviously equal to r12. Coulomb's force law between two point charges q1 and q2 located at vector position r1 and r2 is then expressed as f21 equals to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon q1 q2 divided by r21 square times unit vector r21. Some remarks on equation 1.3 are relevant. Equation 1.3 is valid for any sign of q1 and q2, whether positive or negative. If q1 and q2 are of same sign, either both positive or both negative. F21 is along R21, which denotes repulsion, as it should be for like charges. If Q1 and Q2 are of opposite signs, F21 is along minus R21, which denotes attraction, as expected for unlike charges. Thus, we do not have to write separate equations for the cases of like and unlike charges. Equation 1.3 takes care of both cases correctly. Second point, the force F12 on charge Q1 due to charge Q2 is obtained from equation 1.3 by simply interchanging suffixes 1 and 2, that is F12 is equals to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by R12 square times unit vector R12 equals to negative of force vector F21. Thus, Coulomb's law agrees with Newton's third law. Third point, Coulomb's law gives the force between two charges Q1 and Q2 in vacuum. If the charges are placed in matter or the intervening space has matter, the situation gets complicated due to the presence of charged constituents of matter. We shall consider electrostatics in matter in the next chapter.